Hey everyone, Gary Simon of Corsetro.com, and today we're going to take a look at Angular 2 animations. And you're really able to handle just about any type of animation through any type of property that you can imagine. So you can handle opacity, you can animate position, as well as size. All right, so let's go ahead and start off like we always do. We're going to start by creating a new Angular 2 project. We're going to use the quick start method up here in GitHub. So I'm just going to scroll down and copy this line right here. And then in the terminal, I'm going to go ahead and specify paste here by right clicking and choose a project title such as my-animations. All right, we're going to cd into my-animations and then specify npm install. All right, so because this takes a little bit of time, I'm going to pause like always and I'll come back. Okay, it is done now, so let's go back here and then specify npm start. And we'll go to our browser here, and it's going to load up a new window or tab in this case with localhost 3000. And here it is, it's up and running. Okay, so now what I want to do is real quickly just get a copy of Foundation running, and we're going to use a CDN. And Foundation, by the way, is a CSS front-end framework. We're not going to use it hardly at all. I just want to create a real quick, simple two-column layout, and this will help us do that very easily without writing too much or any CSS regarding the matter. So I just Googled Foundation CDN, and we'll use this top one right here. So we're going to copy that. And then open up your code editor. I'm using Visual Studio Code. And in our project that we just created from the command line, we're going to head over to index.html. And then just above the link rel style sheet, we're gonna add another one. Sheet and href equals and paste that in there and then save it. And then we reload, you'll notice that the font changes, and that means that Foundation is up and running, affecting the CSS. Okay, we're gonna work here in just our single component. So let's open up our app folder and then go to app.component.ts as usual if you've been following along with the series. And the very first thing we need to do when we're working with animation is import some additional members from the Angular core. So the ones that we're going to be adding, we're just going to separate by commas. And so to make things a little bit more readable, if you wish, you can put these on separate lines. So down here, I'm gonna also put trigger, state, style, transition, animate, and then keyframes. And that should be good. Let's go ahead and save this. And then we're going to write, as usual, inline HTML, as well as CSS, and as well as animations once we get to that point. So we're just gonna give ourselves a couple lines here to work with. And I'm going to get rid of the hello Angular, and we're going to put in div class equals row, and this is a foundation specific class. And then inside, if we're gonna create two columns. So div class equals columns. And then we'll copy and paste this one right here. And inside of there, on the left column, we're gonna put in a button. So I'm gonna put button here. And for now, I'm not gonna put anything, any type of attributes inside of it just yet. Press me for animation. And then close it. And then over here, we're going to put a div ID. We're going to make this content. And in the future, we will add additional attributes here. And then just look at me animate. And that's closing div right there. So we're going to have a button here. And once it's pressed, we're going to add some animation on this div right here. So simple enough. Let's go ahead and save that. And let's put in a comma here and let's add in our styles. So let's open it up in brackets, put in our backticks, which is the key just to the left of one. This allows us to put multi-line CSS. Same thing up here as well. And in the styles, Let's go style our button. We just need to give it a larger font size. So button, and we're going to put in font-size 1.8 em. And then after this, let's also reference the content ID, so content. And we're gonna put in just padding, 30 pixels, and then also we'll give it a background color of 6E. So E. Okay. So let's go ahead and save this. And now let's go ahead and look at our browser to see what it looks like. And this is basically what you should have going so far. We click it, of course, nothing happens. All right, so let's go back here. And now let's attach a binding to our button. So this is going to be an event binding and it's going to be based on a click. So we're gonna wrap this around parentheses equals, and we're going to specify a method called toggle move and end it with there, the quotes. And let's go ahead and define that down here. So this will be toggle move and right now it's just console log clicked. So we'll save that and make sure it is refreshed, and we'll hit Control Shift I just to get up our console and clicked. Okay, so now how do we make this right here animate based on this being pressed? Well, to do that, what we want to do is go ahead and in our HTML for div ID content, remember this is the div that, or the HTML element that we want to animate. So what we need to do is wrap here in brackets at, and then we have to give this some type of name that we're going to reference here in our animations information over here. So let's just name this focus panel and then equals, and then we're going to make it equal state. Now this could also be something arbitrary. You can name whatever you wish. However, you have to use it correctly later on in your coding as well. All right, so we'll save this and we have to declare state down here in our app component. We have to define it. So what we want to do is specify state. It's going to be a type of string equals inactive. Now bear with me, a little bit confusing so far, and you'll see how this all comes together. Now let's specify our animations. So down here, we'll put in animations. And what we want to specify is brackets, and inside of here, all of your animations will be contained within this object. And what we want to do, the way you start off a given animation is through trigger. Now remember, we imported trigger up here. So trigger, and then for the arguments, we have to specify a name of some sort. In this case, it's going to be focus panel that we used earlier. So focus panel, and then we put in a comma, and we open up in brackets. This is where we enter and use state. All right, state will define the current, essentially the state that it's in. So we'll open this up in parentheses and we can give this a name of inactive. Notice we reference this here. So we're setting when the app component loads the current state of this div right here as being inactive. And in here we define what exactly inactive means in terms of its styles. So we put a comma and then we specify style and then we open it up parentheses and curly braces. And inside of here, this is where we can put in some CSS properties or as well as transformation and movement properties. So let's go ahead and just put in transform and scale 1. One means whatever its default size currently is. All right, now let's also put in a comma here and define another state. So state, this is going to be active, and we're gonna put in a comma, and then specify style, parentheses and curly braces. Let's go ahead and just copy this real quick. And then we'll put 1.1. And you can put in any value you want, really. You can make it go smaller or larger. Okay, and then after that, we're gonna put in our transition function, which is specified right here. So transition, and we're gonna put in inactive to active. Animate, which is another member that we included. And that's going to be, let's say 100 milliseconds. We're defining the length. And then also the type of animation is in. And then a comma here. Let's just copy this and then paste. We'll go from active to inactive. And we can also define these parameters as we wish right here. So I'll just leave them the same, except this will ease out. Okay, so let's go ahead and save that. And then we will come down to our app component class. And right now we're just console logging. So what we need to do is change the state as we need it to be. So this is going to be a toggle. So we're gonna specify this.state, which is in reference to this property here, equals parentheses this.state inactive. If inactive, then we put a question mark, active, inactive. So let's go ahead and save that. And let's go ahead and look at our browser and hope it works. So let's click it, and there we go. So you notice how it's very smooth, and it's basically toggling this animation. So let's take it a step further, and let's add a second property to animate. So in state, we can define, let's just say, a background color. Background color, make this EEE. And then we'll copy this, and let's just set it to a different color. And how about CFD8DC? So we'll save that. And you'll see how it changes to kind of like a darker blue, similar to this right here. It's default from the styles that we have defined here. Right here, the colors that they're using. Okay, so going further, let's say for example, we wanted to show this here once we load the component here or the project, we want this to animate in automatically. So there's a variety of reasons why you would ever want to do that. Once your app loads or a component loads, you want things to animate in. Well, this is one such way of achieving that. Okay, so what we'll do is come up here to our HTML, and on our div ID here, this is what we want to animate in. We're going to add brackets at move panel, and this is where we're going to create a second trigger called move panel, and equals state, and we're just going to reuse this property here. So we'll save this. And then we want to define that second trigger. So we'll come down just after this trigger, make sure we're inside animations and we have our two brackets here. We're going to put in a comma. And just to make my life a little bit easier, we'll just copy this and then paste it. And then we'll call this move panel. And this time we're going to use something different than just state for inactive or active. We're going to use something called void to and then an asterisk. And that basically means if we're going from the element not being present currently to being present, then we'll follow or we'll make the animation that we're about to define occur. So let's go ahead and put in transition. So we're not going to use a state here. So transition, we're going to put void to all. And then we're going to put in brackets. And inside of there, we'll put in style, transform, and then translate y, because we want it to come from the top of the browser, then down. Open up the parentheses and put in -100%, and then a comma, and then animate for, we'll say 100 milliseconds. So let's go ahead and save that. All right, and you see how it came down. Let me just refresh this. And there we go. And this will also work as well. All right, so what if, for example, we wanted to apply more complex multi-step animations? Well, here's how we'll do that. So going back, we're going to change up our transition just a bit. So inside here, we're going to gut this out and we're going to create an animate function. So animate, and then this is where we specify for the first argument, the duration. Let's just put 600 milliseconds and then keyframes. And inside of here, we put in different steps that we want to animate. So we'll put in style here, and then let's just say we'll go from opacity 0 and then transform from translate y -200 pixels, and then offset is 0, and then put in a comma. Now you'll see what offset means here very shortly. Let's go ahead and copy this and then paste it and then paste it. So we'll have three steps here. You can have as many as you wish, really. So we'll go from opacity 0 to 100% right there. So it's 1. And then translate y will come down 25 pixels past its default starting point. And then here for translate y, we'll have this at 0. We'll leave this at 1 as well here. And for the offset, so if our animate duration is 600 milliseconds, then the offset here, we're starting at 0, so essentially 0 milliseconds. And over here, if we wanted to put, say, 0.5, that means it'll take 300 milliseconds to go from this step to this step, and then also an additional 300 milliseconds if we go from this step right here. So make sure this is at 1. All right, so instead of doing that, though, let's add 0.75. So let's go ahead and save this. So let's go ahead and refresh. And you'll see now that we have a multi-step animation. All right, so that is it for Angular 2 animations. And of course, you can get much more complex when you're using these animations. However, the purpose of this whole series really is just to create, you know, a very brief introduction to all the Angular 2 core concepts. So that is it for this series specifically. However, in the coming days, I'm going to be releasing more advanced or intermediate to advanced tutorials and courses. So hopefully you follow along and you participate. All right, I'll talk to you later.